I was just looking at all this propaganda all over the news networks, and here we are in the fog of war. You really don't know what is actually happening from fiction. And we are reaching heights of Baghdad Bob, beyond Baghdad Bob, of propaganda, of these heroes. And it's really getting funny. It's hilarious when you read some of the stories that people are coming up with. I just wrote down a few of what I've been seeing. Iron Man of Kiev taking out 75 jets in high-tech Iron Man suit developed by NATO scientists. Cougar of Kiev successfully seduced 890 Russian servicemen and got them to switch sides and provide intel to Ukraine. Ghost of Kiev taking out almost 300 Russian planes. Ukraine air defense bent the F up. 150 Russian planes over the Black Sea in Ukraine proper. Columns of Russian hardware for miles and miles sit destroyed. Estimated losses 780 tanks, 250 armored personnel carriers, 375 towed artillery, among others. Russian service members fleeing like crazy and joining Ukraine's side. Britain is delivering high-tech weapons and ammunition. Zelensky personally on the ground, fighting with his soldiers on the front lines to boost morale. Let's remember the Zelensky guy is an actor. He actually played as a Ukraine president as an actor. Here we have people making movies, making fiction, running countries. I guess they learned that from the West. Entire Russian government crippled by sanctions. Even China dissing themselves from Putler. Russia hit the wrong AA sites, so they can't even achieve air superiority. Hundreds of Russian artillery captured intact by Ukrainians. Twitter and Facebook now blocking Russians from making accounts. Russian access to porn sites as Pornhub are blocked. Russian news agency TASS reports that immediately deletes news that over 60,000 Russian troops have died during the invasion already. Somalia imposes sanctions and bans Russian citizens from entering. Canadians remove Russian vodka from their store shelves. This has actually happened in America. This is happening. You have a lot of these liquor, alcohol places, they are removing Russian vodka from being sold. So I guess there's more cheaper Stolichnaya for y'all out there. Okay. Two teens hold off 125 Russian invaders for days before running out of ammunition and resorting to ambush attacks with hammers. Yeah, right. So, yeah, this Ghost of Kiev, they've been talking about this guy, this super fighter. He's taken out 20 jets by himself. And you have this one tank commander, this one tank that took out 20 Russian tanks. So there's just lots of crazy propaganda out there, but that's definitely beyond Baghdad Bob's. You know, everything's okay, everything's fine, you know, we're winning, the war against the Americans. And obviously you could see photos that that wasn't the case. Now, ironically, even if you win a war, it doesn't necessarily mean you won the country. And you could look back at the Desert Storm and all that, and what did it really get us? The Bush government, they dropped a lot of depleted uranium in those cities, and a lot of people are still getting messed up from that. So, you know, the Americans had to pull out of there eventually. So you can only control a country for so long before its people will rise up. Actually, what's happening is with the Russians that they want to overthrow the government. They really are trying to limit as many civilian casualties as possible because this is an information war, and they know that if casualties start piling up, it's going to come out in videos, and you can already see it. They're already trying to make videos in Ukraine where they'll show body bags, people in body bags, right? You see 150 body bags, and you'll see one guy like trying to get out, like he's trying to breathe, and then somebody runs up there and says, "Stop, stop moving, stop moving." They're just trying to overwhelm everybody with this World War III propaganda. They're so greedy and desperate that if they can kill a bunch of people and just get the news onto Russia nonstop so they can look good in 2022 in the midterms, that's their plan. So Biden's gonna come out and say, "We did it! We beat coronavirus," you know? No, I'm too old to be enlisted. I'm in my mid-40s, so I'm not gonna be drafted probably. I'll be like one of the last ones unless, you know, there's like some type of invasion within the United States. And I'll defend my local area, my town, but I ain't going overseas for this bullshit. That's just ridiculous. You're fighting for the bankers, and I'm not gonna do that. I'll fight for my community, but not for bankers. Probably China's just laughing because most of our troops have already went ahead and took that shot. And if most of the military did take it, then who's gonna be left to defend? I think it was Yamamoto who said that every American behind every blade of grass, you can find an American with a gun. And it's good. The more people have guns, the better. Because if you take out our military, then probably 75% of our military, you probably can't count on them long term. So that's a big chunk of men that have been out in the wars and have all that experience. I expect the propaganda to intensify. The more desperate things get, the more you're going to hear about these heroes, superhero Ukrainians. Same thing going on the Russian side. They're probably coming out with all this propaganda, how they're doing so wonderful. But it's probably the truth is somewhere in the middle, as usual. I did see some encouragement as far as Pripyat goes and in Chernobyl and the exclusion zone, that the Russians did take over the facility. They do have troops there, but they are working with the Ukrainian troops to guard together Chernobyl. And I think that is really good news because I was worried they might be fighting in Chernobyl because you think of it as a no-go zone. It's not a place you want to be spending a lot of time at. They were recommending you only stay one day in Chernobyl and then get out. And that's probably too much because you could just breathe in a hot particle and you're fucked. So that is good. They're probably having troops coming in and out, replacing each other. But you could see the Russians have the guns. They're with the Ukrainian soldiers. Ukrainian soldiers don't have guns, but they're working together. So I think that is some positive encouragement. And no, it's not good for either side if Chernobyl goes haywire. It's not good for all of Europe, even us over here. It's not a good thing. Fallout can travel a long way. They hit that dome. I think one guy was mentioning all they'd have to do is hit that dome with a mortar strike, and that would cause a serious problem, even bigger than the Russians attacking Ukraine. That is an even more serious problem for both sides. And we're seeing right now the ruble's just getting decimated. It's not doing good. Their markets are down 50%. The Russians have known this for a long time now that they're going to be pushed out of a lot of markets. They've done a lot of things to build up their own system of doing financing and business around the world order system. Just them having China as their biggest purchasers, I think China just said they're going to take all the excess wheat from Russia. And China has this huge base of people. They're hungry, that Russia will have plenty of products to push on them to keep their economy going. So I think that's the plan over there. Best thing really to happen is you don't want the things to escalate, and they have been, because you have a lot of these countries in Europe. They're just making some outrageous statements. They're just saying, "Oh, well, we need to hold Putin accountable." They start wanting to send more their own troops and equipment, and some even were sending jets, and some are now troops have been going in there from different fighting forces, and they just take off their badge, whatever they're from, and they're fighting on the Ukraine side. So this we're entering a gray area here. And I think now the Russia has their own DEFCON system. It's only one step up from now pressing a button. So that's not where we want to be. They could have about 8,000 nuclear warheads. And if you block 7,000, if you block 80% of their missiles, you still have an overwhelming enough missiles to hit every major American city, military base installation, and this survivability of most of these major American cities is going to be wiped out. And you're only going to have a few people left that went into a cave, went into a mountain that planned well ahead, was able to get like a deep well in a deep cave, and has got a bunch of food down there. That's pretty much the only way you're gonna be able to make it, I think, if things keep going the way they're going. Because we have idiots in control. This thing is the US, just to mind our own business, worry about our own hemisphere, stop trying to be a policeman of the world, and stop telling other countries how to run things. All the money spent, all the trillions of dollars just thrown out the window when we could have done throwing that money into improvements here at home. It's just like a huge waste of blood, sacrifice, and money spent in the wrong ways. So I'm just gonna leave it at that, and thanks for watching.